family, it's your sis Lisa. I hope you're doing well. So today I want to talk to you guys about just judgment and should Christians judge other people? What does that look like? Because I was scrolling through TikTok as one does, and I came across this Christian TikToker who talks about how I shouldn't be able to judge non-Christians, but I should be able to judge Christians. Here's a scripture justifying that. And of course it was only like, at that point, it was only like a 1 minute video. So I was like, I feel like she needs to unpack that thought more because I don't think we're supposed to judge anybody. So I wanted to read the scripture for myself, do my own Bible study, and that's what we're about to do today. So let's get into it. Okay, so the verse I want to talk to you guys about is 1 Corinthians 5:9-13. So let's go on and read through it. When I wrote to you before, I told you not to associate with people who indulge in sexual sin. But I wasn't talking about unbelievers who indulge in sexual sin, or are greedy, or cheat people, or worship idols. You would have to leave this world to avoid people like that. I meant that you are not to associate with anyone who claims to be a believer, yet indulges in sexual sin, or is greedy, or worships idols, or is abusive, or is a drunkard, or cheats people. Don't even eat with such people. It isn't my responsibility to judge outsiders, but it certainly is your responsibility to judge those inside the church who are sinning. God will judge those on the outside, but the scriptures say, you must remove the evil person from among you. So, a lot was said in that passage, wasn't it? So, just a little backstory I should have mentioned before. This was written by Paul. He was an apostle. Paul has a story and a journey into his apostleship. You know what I'm saying? So, I highly recommend just reading more about Paul. If you want to read Acts, that has a lot about Paul in there. So Paul established these churches, and so now he's in prison for, you know, talking about God, and he's writing to these churches. So 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians was written to the church in Corinth. So he's saying, I've written to you before. In previous chapters, he talks about not indulging with people who engage in sexual sin. But this is like a PS, what I really meant was. And then we have these scriptures that we're reading here. So when he talks about not associating with people who are not in the faith, like basically he's saying, don't associate with those people, let God handle them. What you really need to do is judge the people who are in the faith, yet they're being hypocritical and doing all kinds of stuff. Now, when we think of this word judgment, like we can think, the first thought is like we condemn people who are, say they're Christians, but aren't doing this, that, and the third. That's literally not what Paul is talking about. And at first I thought he was. I was like, judge? But I thought we're not supposed to judge anybody. I thought we'd leave that to God. I thought that wasn't my business. So I really had to look at what does judge mean in the Greek in this context. So when we look at the word judge in the Greek in this context, it means to be of opinion, to deem, to think. The word is krino. Again, everything's on the screen so you can see it yourself. But yeah, it's krino. And yeah, to deem or to think or to have an opinion. So I reread the scripture with that in mind. And what I really came to is that Paul is not saying you should condemn people and talk mess about people and tell people they're wrong if they're sinning. That's really not what Paul is saying. That's not his vibe. What he's saying is you don't need to associate with those people because the Bible says we need to rid ourselves of evil, rid ourselves of things that are not of God. Now, that doesn't mean you have to expect everybody to be perfect. But for example, the way I could picture it is, let's say I'm on a diet, right? And I really want to eat ice cream. And I hit up my friend who is not on a diet, has no qualms about eating ice cream. I'm like, girl, let's go get some ice cream. She's going to be like, I bet. And we're going to go get ice cream. That doesn't mean I should stop hanging out with her, but I should stop, you know, relying on her when I need someone to uplift me in my journey of being on a diet, because she's not on a diet. But if I were to hit up someone who's also on a diet and is like really trying not to eat sweets or whatever, and I'm like, hey, I need help not going to get ice cream, or I really want ice cream right now, they can be like, listen, sis, like, just don't get the ice cream. We're gonna go get some smoothies instead. We're gonna go do this instead. Or one thing I do when I'm feeling like a temptation to cheat on my diet is this. So if you think of your diet as basically your Christian life, when you feel led to like sin and you're just like, yo, I'm about to sin, you're not gonna hit up another person who's dealing with that same thing and not addressing it. You're gonna hit up somebody who's probably either past it or someone who's also dealing with it and trying to overcome it. Because if you just talk to someone who's like indulging in a lifestyle that you don't want to indulge in, you're trying actively to avoid, then what are you doing? You're not benefiting yourself. All you're doing is just going deeper into it and not really checking yourself. So in this context, I wouldn't say that Paul is saying we need to judge people and tell them they're wrong and condemn them. What he's really saying is you need to know what is right and what is wrong. And your opinion of right and wrong should shape who you associate with, who you keep close to your heart, who you are going to take advice from, who you're going to lean on when in times when you're struggling, right? So when I started thinking about this, I thought about another scripture that talks about judgment. So we're going to go into Matthew 7, 1 through 5. It says, "Do not judge others, and you will not be judged, for you will be treated as you treat others. The standard you use in judging is the standard by which you will be judged. And why worry about a speck in your friend's eye when you have a log in your own? How can you think of saying to a friend, 'Let me help you get rid of the speck in your eye,' when you cannot see past the log in your own eye? Hypocrite! First, get rid of the log in your eye, then you will see well enough to deal with the speck in your friend's eye." And the reason I started laughing during this is because when I tell y'all, Jesus would just be fed up. He called y'all hypocrites. He said hypocrite. Honestly, Jesus been going off. So this was said by Jesus himself. And that's why I was laughing, because again, Jesus would sometimes just be like, "Listen, y'all, let me tell you what it is and what it isn't." And he would go in, and I love it. But in this context, when we look at the word judge, what it really means is to pronounce judgment, to subject or censure. So we are not to, basically, again, we're not to condemn people. We're not to say, "You're going to hell." Who are you? Only God can say that. Who are you to tell somebody you're going to hell? Or who are you to judge somebody and condemn them? You know? Who are you? Honestly, only God can do that. So basically what I gather from this is mind your own business, take care of you. You know what I mean? And then we can all be minding our business and all growing with God together. You know? And I think that's something that's really important in this passage. It's just like, you ever had somebody try to correct you on something and you're like, "Friend, you need to look in the mirror first. Ain't that the pot calling kettle black?" He's saying, don't be that guy. Don't be the one that points something out when you have your own stuff to work on. Just mind your business. Do you. And another thing we know is that we are called to love our neighbors as ourselves. We are called to love everybody. So even in the way Paul is talking about judgment, where it's like you need to have an opinion of wrong, right and wrong, and not associate with people, that doesn't mean you stop loving somebody. That doesn't mean you're not nice to that person. It just means you can't give all your time to that person. You can't invest in that person. You can't go to that person for advice because it's not going to help you. However, that also doesn't mean that you can be like, "Well, what you really need to do is," like, that's not what God calls us to do. But what God does call us to do is lift each other up, to be a friend, right? So another one of my favorite verses is, "As iron sharpens iron, so friend sharpens friend." So to me, this just means while we are not called to condemn each other, while we are called to love each other, in love, you can offer correction to a friend. If they ask for it, like, "Hey, I'm really struggling with this. Here are some tips. Iron sharpens iron. Here's what I do when I'm like going through that. Iron sharpens iron." But when someone is actively going through something, we are not called to kick them when they're down. That's all I'm really trying to say, is that it is not your business. It is not your job to condemn anybody. It is your job to love everybody and build them up. So I hope that makes some sense. I hope that was helpful. If you have any thoughts you want to share, leave it in a comment down below. I love talking about this stuff with you guys. I love when people comment on these videos and they have like more thoughts to share or questions to ask. And I just love that. So yeah, what are your thoughts on judgment? How do you feel about judgment? Does this convict you a little bit? Have you realized you've been judging someone? Have you ever been judged? I know a lot of us have, because church people be judging sometimes. But you know, we love them anyways, because that's what God calls us to do, is love each other and love everyone. So I hope this was helpful. And yeah, you can follow me on Instagram, hit me up, message me, again, comment below. I love comments on these videos and talking about stuff. And yeah, I appreciate you guys for watching.